Hello everyone, today we are diving into the world of masks in Procreate. Now, if you've ever painted a room, you're probably familiar with masking tape, right? It's used to cover things up so you don't accidentally splatter paint where it doesn't belong. Procreate masks work in a very similar way, but they are way more powerful and versatile than a roll of tape. Masks in Procreate offer a non-destructive method to hide or modify the contents of a layer, giving you unprecedented creative control. In Procreate, masks come in three flavors: alpha lock, clipping masks, and layer masks, and each type has its own unique purpose and advantage. So choosing the right mask depends on various factors. Are you concerned about your layer count, or do you want to play with blending modes, or perhaps you need the flexibility of non-destructive modification? But don't worry, if this sounds a bit overwhelming right now, by the end of this video, it will all make perfect sense, I promise. So let's tackle a common issue. Say you're drawing a monstera leaf, but the marks spill over the edges and you're not a fan of that. So that's where Alpha Lock comes in handy. By enabling Alpha Lock, you keep your marks neatly within the leaf's boundary. Just tap the layer and select Alpha Lock, or you could swipe right with two fingers and you'll notice the checkerboard pattern indicating that Alpha Lock is now active. Now any mark you make stays inside the leaf. Now the only drawback to this is that you can't edit specific areas without altering the entire drawing. And when you're illustrating for a client and you want to have a way to make modifications without destroying the original illustration, this could be a bit of a problem. So you want a more non-destructive way of working. And so that's where I want to introduce clipping masks. To create a clipping mask, just create a new layer above your drawing, then click Clipping Mask. To clip it to the layer below, and you can see there is a little arrow and it's now clipped to the layer. Now you can add your marks and they magically stay within the leaf's outline. And what's great is that you can adjust these marks without touching the original leaf layer. This method offers excellent control, especially for adding light, shade, or other intricate details, and allows for a non-destructive way of working. However, you do have to keep in mind that you might run out of layers. But there are ways to get around that. Clipping masks are probably my favorite type of mask and I use them all the time. And then there are layer masks. So say you wanted to make adjustments to your original layer. Maybe you just want to add some holes to the monstera leaf. I could just use the eraser tool, but by doing it this way, we are once again using a destructive way of illustrating. So that's where the layer mask comes in really handy. So what we do is we select our original art layer and then we select mask. And you can see a white layer above your artwork layer. Think of this as a canvas. When you paint with black, it's like blackout curtains hiding parts of your artwork. If you use white, it's like opening a window revealing your art. If you use something in between, a greyish colour, it becomes a semi-transparent curtain. Now this flexibility allows for intricate adjustments and fine-tuning. I find this useful when I want to slightly modify an illustration without destroying it. So say I just wanted to remove the edge of something but I'm worried I might go too far. What I can do is activate the layer mask, erase the section I want by using black, and notice I'm not using the eraser, I'm using the brush. And if I go too far, I just switch to white and add it back in. Or if I completely change my mind, I can just delete the layer mask altogether and go back to the original. So nothing is lost. Thanks for joining me in this quick journey through the wonderful world of layer masks in Procreate. I hope you found this tutorial both informative and inspiring. Layer masks really are powerful tools that can elevate your digital art, giving you more control, creativity, and more of a professional kind of feel to your work. So don't forget to like this video if you found it helpful, and please do subscribe to my channel for more Procreate tips, tricks, and tutorials. If you have any questions or want to share your creations using these techniques, feel free to leave a comment below. I love hearing your thoughts and seeing your work. If you want to learn how to turn your Procreate illustrations into repeatable patterns, I recommend watching this video here. Keep experimenting, keep creating, and keep pushing your skills to new heights. Until next time, happy creating, and I will see you in the next video.